I'm Dr. Padilla. Welcome or welcome back. Here we talk about all things data visualization. Today we are talking about transforms in VegaLite. Now, transforms are a very important part of the data visualization process. They help us choose which data to visualize, which is just as important as deciding different marks and channels that you would use to visualize your data. So let's jump on in. All right. So the first type of transformation that we're going to talk about is aggregation. The reason that we would aggregate our data is oftentimes with large data sets, it is impractical to visualize all of the individual data points. Instead, what we might want to do is average over various groups. So that is really what aggregation excels at. Now, what we're going to do to start, of course, is to import VegaLite. Go ahead and copy over that code now. And the data set we are going to be working on is from Our World in Data. And what it is data on natural disasters over various years for all of the countries. And for this particular version of the data set, it is counting the number of deaths per natural disaster. So the way we'll actually load this is this code right here. So go ahead and copy that over as well. And this is loading it from my GitHub repository. Now, once you have all of that, we are going to start by creating a very simple bar chart. So we'll start by doing VL mark bar. And the data is going to be the disasters data set that we were specifying just right above. And the way that we're going to call that is we're going to specify it as a URL, as that is where it came from. And we already called it, so we can just write disasters here. And then here we can begin with our encoding. So we are going to just very simply plot the different deaths in different countries. So for our y-axis, we are going to add a quantitative field, and that is going to be deaths. And then for our x-axis, we are going to add a nominal field, and that will be country. Then we'll close all of this out with our render call. I went ahead and just used a hotkey to run that. So what we have here with this code is a simple bar chart that is plotting deaths on the Y and countries on the X, which looks like this. Okay, so this might be your first impulse when looking at a data set. You might just want to create a simple bar chart. Okay, fine. Now, the thing I want to point out to you is when you're looking at this, notice these little white lines here. See, in Bangladesh, there's these little lines. China, you can see these lines too. What is going on is the way that VegaLite is creating this is it is taking the different death counts for various different disasters over various years and really just stacking them up like this. That's why you see these little kind of dashes, because it's the lines are literally being stacked up here. So what we will want to do to make sure it doesn't do that is to use a aggregation call, and we will go ahead and do this calculation, this kind of stacking calculation for it. So rather than it kind of automatically stacking it up, it is going to be given a value that creates this bar here. And the way we would actually do that is with a transform. So very much in line with our traditional grammar of graphics, we are going to go ahead and just add a transform call here. And notice this is above the encoding. We want to add it above the encoding because what we're going to do is manipulate the data. And we want to do that before we actually go and visualize the data here. So for this transform call, what I want to do is I want to summarize the different deaths for the different countries. I want to do that calculation for it. So what I actually have to start with is a group by call. What I'm going to specify here is I want the aggregation to be grouped for the different countries in this data set. So I add that here, and then I'm going to go ahead and add an aggregation call called aggregate. And here is where we start to do the calculation. So I'm going to do VL sum, and it's going to summarize deaths. And what I'm going to do with that information is I'm going to basically create a new value that is called total deaths. So essentially I'm summarizing deaths here, and that is going to be saved as total deaths that I'll then be able to refer to later. So in order to visualize this properly, I'm going to swap out deaths here in the Y and change it out for total deaths. Let's go ahead and give that a run. You might not have seen anything happen, but notice that now we don't have these individual tick marks here, okay? That kind of went away because it's doing the calculation for us, and it changed the Y-axis labeling here to total deaths. That's how you know it actually did something. If you're a little confused, for it would have just said deaths and now it says total deaths. Okay, so we fixed one problem, and we learned that what you can do is you can group by any element within your data set. And then within that particular group, it is going to create a statistic. So in this case, it's summarizing deaths, and we're going to save it as a new attribute that then we can call later down here, which is great. Let's look at some of the other types of aggregations that we can do. We tried sum. We also have the option to try mean. I just ran that and you might not have noticed it, but it quickly changed the values. One way to pay attention is to look at the values on the y-axis here. I'll go back and change it to sum. Let's see if you can see it. Notice that the total values are much, much higher because it's adding them up. And when it's mean, then obviously a great deal smaller because it's taking the mean of these different values, not the sum. Okay, let's try another one. How about count? Okay, something maybe strange looking happened where now it looks like all of the values are the same. What is actually going on for count is for all of these different countries, we have the same number of counts because the data was collected every year for all of these different countries. So this is actually the same. It's basically all of the different counts across these countries. So that's good. It looks crazy, but that's not a problem. Let's try another one. Let's go with max. Okay, what we're seeing here are the max value, the highest number of deaths across these different countries, Bangladesh and so on. Now there's lots more you can do with this aggregate function. I just showed you a sampling. I would encourage you to take a look at the official documentation, which is right here, to really see the full list of things that you can do. While we learned a little bit about this aggregate function here, and we learned how to group by, notice that this visualization is still pretty rough. It is hard to compare the different countries to one another, even though we do get some nice summary statistics here. So the next type of transform that we are going to talk about is sort. And sort will help us more easily look at high and low values across this data set.